The four different techniques that we just discussed have a number of pros and cons. So next, we're going to discuss the main pros and cons for these techniques, so as to be able to compare them. When testing is concerned, the main positive about this technique is that it does not generate false alarms. In other words, it doesn't generate false positives. What that means is that when testing generates a failure, that means that there is an actual problem in the code. The main limitation of testing, however, is that it is highly incomplete. Consider again the picture that we drew a little earlier, the one representing the input domain of the program being tested. Even in the best scenario, testing can consider only a tiny fraction of the program domain, and therefore a tiny fraction of the program's behavior. And we'll say a lot more about that in the following lessons. Static verification, unlike testing, has the main advantage that it considers all program behaviors. If we look back at our diagram, whereas testing will select only a few of those inputs, static verification will consider them all. Unfortunately, however, this comes at a price. Due to limitation of this kind of analysis and due to infeasibility issues, static verification considers not only all the possible behaviors, but also some impossible behaviors. And what that means is that static verification can generate false positives. And this is in fact the main issue with static verification techniques. As we will further discuss later in the class, static verification can generate results that are not true. For example, it might report a possible null pointer dereference that cannot actually occur in practice. The strongest point about inspections is that when they are done in a rigorous way, they are systematic and they result in a thorough analysis of the code. They are nevertheless a manual process, a human process, so they're not formal, and their effectiveness may depend on the specific people performing the inspection, so its results can be subjective. Finally, the main pro about formal proofs of correctness is that they provide strong guarantees. So they can guarantee that the program is correct, which is not something that any of the other approaches can do, including static verification. But the main limitation of formal proofs is that they need a formal specification, a complete mathematical description of the expected behavior of the whole program. And unfortunately, such a specification is rarely available, and it is very complex to build one. In addition, it is also very complex and possibly expensive to prove that the program corresponds to a specification. That is a process that requires strong mathematical skills and therefore very specialized personnel.